Philippine lawmakers approve on final reading House Bill 7446, or the bill that seeks to amend the bank secrecy law. The measure aims to empower the central bank to investigate bank deposits in the fight against corruption and financial crimes. It will lift barriers in the investigation and prosecution of corrupt or illegal financial actions of stockholders, owners, directors, trustees, officers or employees of entities supervised and regulated by the BSP. The bill will also enable the BSP to inquire into deposits when investigating banks that have been closed. It, however, limits the use of the results from these examinations exclusively to the BSP, SEC, PDIC, Anti-Money Laundering Council, the DOJ, and the courts. The House will now transmit the bill to the Senate for action. The Philippine Environment Department looking to improve policies on reclamations. Experts and stakeholders convened in a forum on Monday to give their recommendations for the planned review. The DENR says this is part of the administration's efforts to prioritize economic transformation while building community resilience from the hazards of climate change. The agency notes among laws and policies that need to be reviewed and enhanced are Executive Order 74, from 2019, which covers the transfer of the Philippine Reclamation Authority to the Office of the President. DENR Administrative Order No. 2003-30, which tackles implementing rules and regulations for the Philippine Environmental Impact Statement System. And DALG Memorandum Circular No. 2022-18, which clarifies the role of LGUs on the Philippine Environmental Impact Statement System. Power interruptions hit parts of Luzon on Monday after several power plants shut down amid the hot weather. Three others, meanwhile, ran on lower power capacities. The country's power grid operator placed Luzon on a red alert status from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. and 6 p.m. to 8. But the NGCP admits the rotational brownouts could happen again due to a spike in power demand. The Energy Department, meanwhile, wants the NGCP to explain the forced outages.
Freak itong nangyari na to na bumagsak yung isang linya just because it was raining. Hindi normal yan. So they have to investigate why it happened.
Power distributor Medalco says some 300,000 customers were affected by the power interruption.
I think titingnan pa nila talaga yung naging sanhi because meron yatang information. It may also be transmission related. So antayin na lang namin kung ano yung talagang naging source ng problema, but there was insufficiency of supply kasi.
Parts of Metro Manila and Rizal will experience water interruptions all throughout this week due to maintenance work. Water concessioners Maynilad and Manila Water had said this is part of their preventive maintenance activities to ensure the condition of their water pipes.
This is in line with activities such as yung pagre-repair ng mga leaks, pagre-replace ng mga valves or yung mga lumang pipe segments, at saka yung tinatawag na natin na network diagnostics. Kasi kailangan din natin ma-ensure na yung pipes natin ay nasa maayos na kondisyon. Pag hindi kasi natin ito gagawin, baka lalong maapektuhan yung efficiency ng ating network.
Some Maynilad customers in Quezon City, Valenzuela, and Caloocan will experience 5 to 8 hours of water interruption, while Manila Water consumers will only experience less than 6 hours of service interruption. Maynilad also announced the daily water service interruptions in parts of Cavite, Muntinlupa, Las Piñas, Parañaque, and Pasay City will be extended until May 16. Consumer demand to soften amid expectations of a recession and weakening currencies. That's according to PricewaterhouseCoopers 2023 Global Consumer Insights Pulse Survey, which was done in February but released only now. The survey says 53% of Filipino consumers admit to being concerned about their personal financial situation. That is higher than the 48% registered for APAC in general. While more Filipinos are also cutting back on non-essential spending compared to just 65% of respondents in the region. 16% say they stopped altogether, while 64% say they are holding back. Over the next 6 months, Filipinos say they expect to spend less on fashion, home, entertainment, and electronics. Philippine Senator Francis Escudero says many provisions in the Maharlika Investment Fund bill will still need to be ironed out. He is questioning a provision that allows the Land Bank and Development Bank of the Philippines to invest separately in the Maharlika Fund despite their proposed merger. Escudero also raises concern on whether the two banks could deliver the earnings expected from them once they invest in the fund. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri earlier said the upper chamber is looking to approve the measure establishing the Sovereign Wealth Fund by the end of this month.
They're getting money from Land Bank and DBP separately, and yet they plan to merge it. Which will come first? Uh-oh. Number two, DBP and Land Bank have investments that are earning anywhere between 6% to 8%. If DBP and Land Bank will invest in the Maharlika Fund, then they should earn at least 6 and 8% too, if that is correct. Otherwise, the Banco Central will question these investments, or they can turn a blind eye. But then again, government securities, whenever government issues a bond, they pay, government pays 6%. So why pay 7% or 8%? Why give Land Bank and DBP 7% or 8% when you can just simply issue a government security and pay interest at 6%? It's by far cheaper.